Thanks for watching this edition of Reviewing America. Today we're off to the unique Black Hills of South Dakota in the small town of Keystone. Nestled in a cozy pine-covered valley, Keystone is only home to around 300 people, but it serves as a perfect spot to base your trip to the Black Hills. Located only 2 miles from Mount Rushmore, there's no question that Keystone can be very busy during the summer months, with all kinds of tourism traffic headed up to see the famous presidents. However, what many travelers don't know is how much more there is to do here, and that the optimal time of year to visit just may be on the fringe of the summer months, in April and May, and September and October. These months can serve up some of the year's nicest weather and smallest crowds. Our visit took place at the end of October, and our highs were in the 60s and lows in the 40s. During this time, we were able to get a better idea of just what all there is to do here. From scenic drives, museums, caves, fishing, shopping, or just lounging around your luxurious hotel room, you can find just about anything in and around Keystone. Walking around the downtown area, you'll find many different gift shops, snack shops, and lots of places to sit down and eat, including the Railhead Restaurant.
We here at the Railhead offer a lot of things. We have free buffets. We have a breakfast buffet, we have a lunch buffet, and we have a dinner buffet. Everybody says, well, why should we go to Keystone this time of the year? Well, let me tell you, there's a lot of attractions here, and I'll tell you what, it all happens right here in Keystone. You've got the train across the street that is the attraction that goes back and forth to Hill City. You've got the tram, you've got the Wax Museum, you've got Mount Rushmore, you've got Crazy Horse, you've got Iron Mountain Road. I can go on and on and on. And here on Main Street, you got a lot of nice stores for souvenirs. Now, when you come to Keystone, it takes more than one day to see everything. I've had people come here a week and a half, and they still don't see it all. I tell you what, if you want a great vacation, this is the place to be, Keystone, South Dakota.
In the downtown gift shops, you'll find everything, like Black Hills gold jewelry, t-shirts, and even artwork built with machine parts. It's an easy walk with ample parking, and you will be sure to find any type of gift or keepsake you're looking for. And for a great place to eat, try Big Time Pizza. Here you will find a wide variety of specialty pizzas, and the taste is truly amazing. Keystone is the perfect place to use as your home base while taking advantage of the myriad of other things to see and do in the southern Black Hills. Custer State Park is less than a 30-minute drive from Keystone, and it offers a look at a wide variety of scenic views and roaming wildlife, all while driving on one of their 3 scenic highways.
Custer State Park, which is located in the southern Black Hills of South Dakota, encompasses about 71,000 acres of varied natural beauty. We have one of the largest buffalo herds in the United States, encompassing around 1,500 head of bison. We also have elk, bighorn sheep, white-tailed deer, and mule deer, numerous birds of prey and songbirds, and a variety of smaller mammals, amphibians, and reptiles. Custer State Park encompasses around 50 to 60 miles of hiking trails. They range everywhere from easy to strenuous. Custer State Park has 3 scenic byways. One is called the Needles Highway, which is Highway 87 North. We also have Iron Mountain Road, which is on the eastern side of the park, Highway 16A, and of course the most famous, the Wildlife Loop Road. We want people to really be exposed to the park and its beauty, not just from the roadways, but from the hiking trails and the biking paths, from the campgrounds, from the picnic areas. Whether it's visiting with our staff, taking in some of our programs, walking on some of our guided trail hikes, anything that we can do to help visitors understand the park, understand its legacy for South Dakota and the country, we greatly appreciate their phone calls.
Beyond Custer State Park to the south, there's Crazy Horse Memorial to the west. This magnificent mountain carving is taking place as we speak. When visiting the Orientation Center, you can watch a movie about Crazy Horse, view historical pictures and paintings, pick up a free souvenir rock from the mountain, and even get a bite to eat at the Laughing Water restaurant. You will be amazed at everything Crazy Horse has to offer.
The project started in 1948. In 1998 we had our 50th anniversary, which is the unveiling of the face of Crazy Horse. Some of the major things were getting the road built all the way on the back, because Dad used to climb the mountain on a 741 step staircase. And then the other major break was the tunnel underneath the arm, so that you could see daylight through the mountain, so we could get that started. But other than that, every year we see people coming and learning more and wanting to know about Native American history, wanting to know more about the culture of the Native American people. And we're just pleased with the interest and everything that is drawn.
Now, of course, a trip to Keystone would not be complete without taking a trip to Mount Rushmore.
The presidents on the mountain are George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Teddy Roosevelt, and Abraham Lincoln, and they represent our nation, the first 150 years of the nation's history, with George Washington being the first president, representing the beginning of our country, Thomas Jefferson, the expansion westward. Teddy Roosevelt represents the development of the nation, and Abraham Lincoln represents the preservation of the nation. There is no entrance fee, but we do have a parking fee of $8 per car or $50 for buses.
Now, you'd think lodging in a place like Keystone could be limited, but for a town this small, there's a great deal to choose from. From the First Lady Inn to the Holiday Inn, there's a little of everything. And if you think that big city elegance is nowhere to be found, look again at Rushmore Express.
My husband and I have traveled all over the world, and we decided when we added on these suites that we wanted to bring and incorporate all of the things that we enjoyed most at the hotels where we had stayed. All of our suites have heated granite floors. There are two LCD TVs in each of the rooms. Our executive suites have large meeting tables, and we can cater in-suite lunches.